Our topic is amplitude modulation or AM. Here we talk about standard AM, that is double sideband full carrier. So the amplitude modulation is the process of changing the amplitude of a high frequency carrier signal in proportion with the instantaneous value of the modulating signal. Or simply we can say that in amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the high frequency carrier signal is changed according to the massive signal or baseband signal. And we know that for a modulation process, we require a two signal. First is massive signal or modulating signal or baseband signal, and second is called a high frequency carrier signal. And here we are going to express amplitude modulation mathematically. For this, we consider massive signal and carrier signal, that is of sinusoidal one. The massive signal is denoted by M function of T, that is A suffix M cos omega M T. And carrier signal is represented as C function of T, and it is equals to A suffix C cos omega C T. Here omega M is written as 2 pi F M T. While in case of carrier signal, omega C is 2 pi F C T. Here F suffix M is the frequency of the modulating signal, whereas F suffix C is the frequency of the carrier signal. Here the frequency of the carrier signal is very large as compared to the modulating signal or baseband signal. Here the massive signal contains information only, and the purpose of the carrier wave is just to carry this information from one place to another. And here we talk about amplitude modulation. So the amplitude of the carrier signal is changed according to the massive signal. So here we note one point. Practically, the amplitude of the carrier signal and the massive signal are measured in volts. So to get the amplitude modulated wave, the amplitude of the carrier is changed by adding a massive signal, and we get a modulated signal, that is of high frequency signal, and this is called AM signal. Here the term within bracket is AC plus MT, and this is called envelope of AM wave. So this first equation is called amplitude modulated signal, that is called standard AM, and this is of high frequency signal having a carrier frequency F suffix C. Now using equation 1, we take a common A suffix C. So within bracket we get 1 plus 1 upon AC into MT into cos 2 pi FCT. Here we get a new term, that is 1 upon AC, and we call it K suffix A. This is called amplitude sensitivity of the modulator, and this is a constant measured in volt inverse, because we know that amplitude of the carrier is measured in volts. This amplitude sensitivity of the modulator is responsible for the generation of the AM wave. Now we take equation 1, that is the equation of the standard AM, written as ST equals to within bracket AC plus MT cos 2 pi FCT. Now we open the bracket, we get two terms. First term is AC cos 2 pi FCT plus MT cos 2 pi FCT. Here the first term is called a carrier, while the second term, which contains a massive signal, is called a sideband. So the standard AM is a double sideband full carrier, because here the sideband as well as carrier is present. If the carrier is present, it is called full carrier. So we can say that standard AM is double sideband full carrier. Now we again take equation 1, but in this time we put the value of massive signal, that is MT equals to AM cos 2 pi FMT. Now taking common A suffix C, and we get within bracket 1 plus AM upon AC cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Here we get a new term that is called a modulation factor, and it is a ratio of AM upon AC. Modulation factor is denoted by mu, and it is a dimensionless constant. And it is a very important term that decides the degree of modulation. Modulation factor is also known as modulation index or depth of modulation. And its formula is the ratio of amplitude of message signal upon the amplitude of the carrier signal. Now, we can write the standard AM in terms of modulation index. And the equation become ST equals to AC within bracket 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now again we open this bracket and we get first term AC cos 2 pi FCT, that is the carrier term, and the second term is AC into mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. For the simplification, in the second term we can use a formula 2 cos A cos B, that is cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Here in place of 2 pi FCT we can write omega C, and in place of 2 pi FMT we can write omega M. And after using the formula we get the standard AM in terms of full carrier and double sideband. The equation is AC cos omega CT plus 1 upon 2 AC into mu within bracket cos omega C plus omega M into T plus cos omega C minus omega M into T. Here the upper sideband is a term that contain a positive sign, and the lower sideband is the term which contain a negative sign. And when we combine the upper sideband and lower sideband, we get a double sideband. Hence the standard AM is called a amplitude modulation double sideband full carrier, or in short DSB FC. Here we note a point, since for a modulation process we require a two signal, that is a message signal which is low frequency signal and a carrier signal that is a very high frequency signal. So when we apply this formula, omega C is very much larger than omega M. So in second term, that is for LSB, we always write omega C minus omega M. And this is called time domain description of AM wave. Next is to determine the frequency domain description of standard AM, that is double sideband full carrier, we apply a Fourier transform on time domain equation. Before starting this, we review some Fourier transform properties. First is impulse signal. Impulse signal is denoted by del t, and its value is 1 at time t equals to 0. The Fourier transform of impulse is equals to 1 and is denoted by del omega, and 1 is the constant for entire range of omega. Next is constant 1 in time domain. The Fourier transform of constant 1 is 2 pi del omega. That is the impulse in frequency domain having value 2 pi. So we remember these two formula, that is the Fourier transform of del t is 1 and Fourier transform of 1 is 2 pi del omega. Next we discuss time shifting and frequency shifting property. As we know that the Fourier transform of any function ft is equals to capital F omega. And if there is a shifting in time domain, that is Fourier transform of ft minus capital T. Here there is a shifting of capital T. Minus sign indicate there is a delay. So in this case the Fourier transform of shifted signal is capital F omega e to power minus j omega t. So according to time shifting property of Fourier transform, if there is a shifting of plus minus capital T, in this case there is a multiplication of exponential e to power plus minus j omega capital T with capital F omega. Next is frequency shifting. If there is a shifting in frequency domain, that is capital F omega minus plus omega naught. So in this case, there must be a multiplication or exponential in time domain with opposite sign. So here we note a point. In case of time shifting property, there is a multiplication or exponential with same sign, whereas in case of frequency shifting, there is a multiplication or exponential in time domain with opposite sign. For example, if there is a frequency shifting, that is F omega minus omega naught, so there is a multiplication of e to power j omega naught t with ft in time domain. So for the representation of frequency domain description of amplitude modulation, we require a frequency shifting property. Now, with the help of frequency shifting, we can determine the Fourier transform of e to power j omega naught t. Here, we simply multiply 1 with e to power j omega naught t and we call it any function ft. And we know that the Fourier transform of constant 1 is 2 pi del omega. And if there is a multiplication of exponential in time domain, so there must be a frequency shifting. So in this case, the Fourier transform of e to power j omega naught t is 2 pi del omega minus omega naught, because here the exponential having a positive sign, so there is a shifting in frequency domain with negative sign. So the Fourier transform of e to power j omega naught t is 2 pi del omega minus omega naught, and in place of omega naught we can write 2 pi f naught. So in this case, the Fourier transform of e to power j 2 pi f naught t is del f minus f naught. So for our requirement, we can write in terms of omega as well as in terms of frequency f. Similarly, the Fourier transform of e to power minus j 2 pi f naught t is del f plus f naught. Now, with the help of these information, we can determine the Fourier transform of cos omega naught t. Here, cos omega naught t can be written in terms of exponential, and this is e to power j omega naught t plus e to power minus j omega naught t upon 2. Here, 1 upon 2 is constant, so we take it outside the bracket. The first term is Fourier transform of e to power j omega naught t, and its value is 2 pi del omega minus omega naught. And the second term is the Fourier transform of e to power minus j omega naught t, and its value is 2 pi del omega plus omega naught. From these two terms, we can take 2 pi common, and after this, we get a Fourier transform of cos omega naught t equals to pi within bracket del omega plus omega naught plus del omega minus omega naught. Similarly, we can determine the Fourier transform of any function ft cos omega naught t, and its value is 1 upon 2 within bracket f capital F omega minus omega naught plus capital F omega plus omega naught. Here, we use a frequency shifting property, and this is called a modulation theorem that is used to determine the frequency domain description of AM wave or standard AM. For this, we take any arbitrary signal in time domain, we call it function ft, and the Fourier transform of this arbitrary signal is again arbitrary frequency spectrum. So here we represent an arbitrary frequency spectrum, that is a Fourier transform of any assumed signal ft, we call it capital F omega, and the bandwidth is capital W. After modulation, that is multiplication of ft with cos omega naught t, we find the Fourier transform. So according to modulation theorem, the spectrum that is situated at the origin is shifted to plus minus omega naught. And here we show a band, that is upper side band and lower side band. The upper side band is between omega naught and omega naught plus W, whereas the lower sideband is omega naught minus W to omega naught. We simply say the band above omega naught is upper side band, or the band below omega naught is lower side band for positive frequencies, and reverse order for negative frequencies. So here we note a point. The modulation simply translates the frequency component of one value to another by shifting the frequency spectrum from origin to plus minus omega naught. Next is existence of negative frequencies. While determining the Fourier transform, there exist a negative frequencies, because the frequency spectrum of any signal is always an even function of omega. Physically, the negative frequencies does not exist, but we convert it into positive frequencies by translating the frequency component to any other value. Now, with the help of these information, we are ready to determine the frequency spectrum of standard AM, that is double sideband full carrier. So next topic is frequency domain description of AM wave, or we call it frequency spectrum of AM wave. We know that the Fourier transform of e to power j 2 pi fct is del f minus fc, that is with the help of frequency shifting property. Similarly, the Fourier transform of e to power minus j 2 pi fct is del f plus fc. When we multiply some function, here we take a message signal mt, then the Fourier transform of e to power j 2 pi fct into mt is capital M f minus fc. Also, the Fourier transform of e to power minus j 2 pi fct into mt is equal to capital M f plus fc. Here we use the frequency shifting property of Fourier transform, and the Fourier transform of cos omega ct is pi within bracket del omega plus omega c plus del omega minus omega c. Fourier transform of message signal mt is capital M function of f, and the Fourier transform of carrier signal, that is a suffix c cos omega ct, is ac by 2 within bracket del f plus fc plus del f minus fc. Now we can determine the frequency domain description of AM wave. For this, we first write the AM wave in time domain, that is standard form, written as s function of t equals to a suffix c within bracket 1 plus ka into mt into cos omega ct. Here k suffix a is called amplitude sensitivity of the modulator, and its value is 1 upon ac. Now to determine the Fourier transform, we open the bracket. So the first term is ac cos 2 pi fct, and the second term is ac into ka into mt cos 2 pi fct. So we find the Fourier transform of both the terms individually. So in the first term, ac is constant, so we take it outside, and the Fourier transform of cos 2 pi fct is obtained after converting to exponential terms. In the second term, the constant is ac into ka, and in this case we have to determine the Fourier transform of mt into cos 2 pi fct. Here again we convert cos 2 pi fct in terms of exponential terms. So after converting cos 2 pi fct in terms of exponent term, that is e to power j 2 pi fct plus e to power minus j 2 pi fct upon 2, and open the bracket, we obtain the frequency domain equation of standard AM, that is denoted by s function of f, and it is equals to ac upon 2 del f minus fc plus ac upon 2 del f plus fc plus ka into ac upon 2 capital M f minus fc plus ka ac upon 2 into capital M f plus fc. Here the first two terms represent the impulse function that occur at plus minus fc having value ac by 2, and the third and fourth term represent the original spectrum of message signal that is shifted in frequency domain by plus minus fc. Here the value is Ka into AC by 2. According to this equation, we represent the frequency spectrum of a baseband signal having bandwidth W as shown in figure A. In the above equation, the first two terms represent the frequency spectrum of a carrier signal, that is denoted by C function of F. It consists of two impulse functions that occur at plus minus FC and having a value AC by 2 as shown in figure B. Now after modulation, the frequency spectrum of baseband signal as shown in figure A is shifted to plus minus FC as shown in figure C. In this figure, at plus minus FC there is an impulse which represent a carrier as well as the spectrum that is shifted from origin to plus minus FC. At plus FC, the impulse is AC by 2 del F minus FC and corresponding spectrum having a value Ka AC by 2 capital M F minus FC. And to the negative side, that is at minus of FC, there is an impulse whose value is AC by 2 del F plus FC and corresponding spectrum having a value Ka AC by 2 capital M F plus FC. On this spectrum of AM signal, we represent the upper sideband and lower sideband, which is USB and LSB. Upper sideband is above a carrier frequency and its range is from FC to FC plus W. And lower sideband extend from FC minus W to FC. And by considering only the positive frequencies, the bandwidth of the AM wave is twice of W. That is twice the bandwidth of the message signal. It is also called transmission bandwidth. So we note the point, the transmission bandwidth of a standard AM, that is double sideband full carrier, is twice of the bandwidth of message signal. And to determine the transmission bandwidth, we take a positive frequencies. Here the highest frequency component is FC plus W and the lowest frequency component is FC minus W. So after taking the difference between the two frequencies, we get a transmission bandwidth that is equals to twice of W.